in unserem nächsten Vortrag spricht Container über das Thema, ist das Kunst oder ist das einfach nur schön? Nach einem kurzen Intro habt ihr hier die Möglichkeit, alle gemeinsam während des Vortrags mitzuzeichnen. Das heißt, wenn ihr euch vielleicht schon mal einen Satz Stift und Papier besorgen wollt oder ein Tablet oder eine Leinwand oder was auch immer euch halt hilft, euch dabei zu entspannen, dabei Spaß zu haben, macht das doch. Auch dies eine Form des verteilten Chaos. Und wer mag, kann gerne hinterher das über Social Media verteilen. Das ist aber überhaupt nicht Pflicht. Es geht um den reinen Spaßfaktor. Und ich hoffe, ihr habt dabei viel Spaß. Und erinnert euch dran, ihr könnt ins Pad schreiben für alle Fragen, für alles Feedback. Und bei dem Vortrag werden wir das so machen, dass live, während ihr also alle gemeinsam zeichnet, ich immer mal wieder ein paar Fragen vorlese oder ein bisschen Feedback reinstreue. Und wünsche euch damit dann ganz viel Spaß.
Ja, ich sage vielen Dank für diese nette Ankündigung. Insofern ganz herzlich willkommen zum, ich sage jetzt mal, kürzesten Teil des Ganzen. Wir werden uns ein bisschen kurz mit den Fragen beschäftigen, ist das Kunst oder ist das einfach nur schön? Bin da im Vorhinein schon gefragt worden, ob das nicht ein bisschen ironisch ist, ob das nicht doppelt gemoppelt ist. Das ist ein bisschen basierend auf dem Spruch, ist das Kunst oder kann das weg? Den fand ich schon immer ein bisschen gemein, weil selbst wenn das nur ein Farbklecks auf der Leinwand ist, hat sich ja irgendjemand mal was dabei gedacht und möchte damit etwas sagen und ausdrücken. Und deswegen finde ich die Frage, ist das Kunst oder ist das nur schön, immer ein bisschen netter. Kleiner Disclaimer vorweg. Ich bin sehr, sehr vieles, aber ich bin ganz bestimmt nicht perfekt. Und genau das ist der Punkt des Vortrags. Das ist der Grund, warum wir heute auch ein bisschen zusammen malen wollen. Es soll heute ein bisschen um Motivationen gehen. Es soll darum gehen, dass man sich mal was traut und vielleicht nicht immer drauf guckt, ob das Ergebnis jetzt perfekt ist oder nicht. Weil ich das ganz oft erlebt habe, dass Menschen mich angeguckt haben, mich gefragt haben, oh, du kannst so toll zeichnen, ich würde das auch so gerne können und ich traue mich das aber nicht. Und genau deswegen ist dieser Vortrag da, weil ich eben auch nicht perfekt bin und eigentlich auch, wie ihr jetzt vielleicht an den Bildern schon sehen könnt, eigentlich analog mehr zeichne als digital. Jetzt habe ich mir für den Vortrag ein Grafiktablet gekauft. Mal gucken, wie gut das geht. Ich bin jetzt eine Woche am Üben. Wir schauen mal. Ein bisschen was zu mir. Moin, ich bin Container. Ich komme aus dem schönen Flensburg und ich habe eigentlich schon immer ganz gerne gemalt, gerne gezeichnet, aber eigentlich meistens mit sehr viel Angst vor dem Ergebnis. Da gab es Perfektionismus, Bestreben, die ich nicht erfüllen konnte und deswegen war ich am Ende meistens von allem und jedem und am meisten von mir selber frustriert. Und habe deshalb sehr lange sehr wenig gezeichnet. Das hat sich dieses Jahr so im Januar, Februar, als das Ganze mit Corona losging, ein bisschen geändert. Da habe ich angefangen, wieder mehr zu zahlen und Ich habe angefangen, ein bisschen mehr zu malen und habe sehr viel Spaß dran gefunden und habe mich sogar ein bisschen gewundert, wie gut es plötzlich ging. Und zwar habe ich damals angefangen, ein bisschen mal mit Farben einfach rumzupanschen und dabei kam zum Beispiel dieser Keufisch raus und ich war völlig überrascht, dass ich sowas konnte. Ich habe so etwas noch nie geschafft. Ich war nie der Meinung, dass ich so etwas wie Kunst überhaupt machen könnte. Und plötzlich hatte ich da etwas vor mir, was an allen Ecken und Enden Fehler hatte, was anatomisch nicht korrekt war, was von den Farben her total komisch aussah. Da war Farbe auch übergelaufen, wo sie nicht überlaufen sollte. Und irgendwie war das trotzdem schön. Und dann habe ich noch einen gemacht, um zu gucken, war das ein Unfall? Und ich habe noch einen gemacht. Und ich habe noch einen gemacht. Und noch einen. Und irgendwie kam dabei heraus, dass das irgendwie trotzdem schön ist und dass ich dafür offenbar gar nicht so viel können muss, wie ich immer dachte. Ich habe dann ein bisschen weiter geübt, ein bisschen weiter gemalt. Dann kamen zum Beispiel solche Bilder dabei raus, die einfach random von mir gezeichnet wurden, wo ich immer wieder überrascht war, dass ich so etwas überhaupt wirklich kann und dass ich etwas erschaffen kann, was ich schön finde und was offenbar auch andere schön finden. Und ja, habe mich eigentlich über mich selber nur noch gewundert, weil ich das vorher nie geschafft hatte und es war nicht schwer und das war das Allerinteressanteste für mich. dann auch nochmal Sachen aus meiner Schulzeit wiederentdeckt, wie Aquarellfarben. Farben, fürchterliches Thema eigentlich immer für mich. Konnte ich nie mit umgehen, war immer fürchterlich, sah scheiße aus und wollte ich eigentlich nie wieder anfassen. Und plötzlich kamen da aber solche Sachen bei raus und ich hatte nichts verändert. Und ich glaube, das war der Punkt, wo das ein bisschen anfing, dass ich sowas raustragen wollte, dass ich Menschen dazu ermutigen wollte, sich zu trauen, auch mal wieder Kunst anzufassen, auch auf die Gefahren, dass sie vielleicht nicht so viel können oder nie so viel Kunst gemacht haben. Und da kamen diese Ponys ins Spiel. Die habe ich irgendwann mal in der Schulzeit angefangen zu malen, so Kritzeleien auf dem Arbeitsbogen. Und ich habe gedacht, mit dem, was ich jetzt irgendwie zustande bringe, muss das doch möglich sein, davon mehr zu machen. Und was man an diesen Ponys sehr gut sehen kann, ist, es sind sehr, sehr einfache Formen. Da ist nichts großartig Kompliziertes dran. Die sind sehr stark simplifiziert. Und so etwas kann meiner Meinung nach jeder malen, der einen Stift in der Hand halten kann. Und genau deshalb wollte ich halt heute hier sein und das machen. Und habe einen Kanal gefunden auf YouTube, der heißt Kritzelpixel. Das ist eine ganz großartige Frau, die mir etwas erzählte von Kunst und dem Handwerk Kunst. Und plötzlich macht es für mich sehr viel Sinn, warum ich meine Bilder plötzlich schöner fand. Weil sie wirklich reine Kunst sind. Kunst ist erstmal alles, was etwas ausdrückt, was eine Geschichte erzählt oder was irgendwelche Gefühle auslöst. Und das Faszinierende ist, für Kunst selber muss ich nicht viel können. Das, glaube ich, kann jeder bestätigen, der mal einen Eimer Farbe auf eine Wand gekippt hat. Das sieht irgendwie ganz nett aus, da ist ein Muster dabei, aber viel gekonnt hat man dafür eben auch nicht. Aber trotzdem macht das manchmal was mit einem. Wenn man ein schwarzes Bild in einen Flur hängt, dann hat das auch manchmal schon eine Auswirkung, ohne dass es dafür viel braucht. Ich kann mit Strichmenschen eine ganz großartige Geschichte erzählen, ohne dass das irgendein Problem ist. Und ich kann aber auch auf der anderen Seite, wenn ich jetzt darauf bestehe, dass ich genau das, was ich in meinem Kopf habe, auf Papier bringen möchte, kann ich das Handwerk Kunst lernen. Und das Faszinierende ist, dass das gar nicht viel mit Können oder mit Talent zu tun hat, sondern mit Üben, mit sich dransetzen und immer weitermachen, egal ob das Ergebnis jetzt gerade perfekt ist oder nicht. Genau dafür sind Übungen da, dass ich eben erstmal meine Fehler machen kann, dass ich mich ausprobieren kann, dass ich üben kann, wie ich es vielleicht besser machen möchte. Und da komme ich auch mal auf ein paar Twitter-Accounts zu sprechen, die ich euch ein bisschen auch ans Herz legen möchte, weil wir da eben auch sowas haben. Die Kunst kann mit einem Strich Menschen wunderbar erzählt werden. Ist lieb, ist ein großartiges Beispiel dafür. Erzähl mir nix.
You're allowed to experiment. And you're allowed to become better your own way. Now, I want to come to my Twitter account and Twitter accounts that show you that you can tell stories using very simple expressions. There are many German artists that are well known for their stick figure drawings that have a very deep meaning. I think that anyone can draw a stick figure. Everyone has done it. In school, for example, when playing hangman, we were all able to draw a stick figure. So I think that many people underestimate what they can do with simple techniques like that. So this is why I would like to encourage you to draw along. And you will notice that it's not about skills. The only skill you need is being able to hold a pen and draw on paper. And I think that anyone can do that. I also I'm going to show you some of my drawings, which are pretty simple. It's actually just circles and then some details. So I would like to invite you to join, because art is everything. Art expresses, it tells stories, it evokes feelings. And a fellow student of mine said, if you don't want to discuss, then it's what's in a museum. I think that is a nice motto. My art isn't in a museum, and it needn't be hanged in a museum. But things that are in a museum for their own right, they have a purpose of being there because they express something. And if this art expresses something, I can do it too because I can express myself. And it's about having fun. Having fun should be the most important factor in art. So we just should just begin creating. Now, I'm going to use Krita, which is my tool of choice for painting. I'm an analog painter. I mainly do watercolors, pencil, but I normally don't use graphic tools, so don't expect a lot. But this is what it's going to be about, just that, not expecting a lot. So I'll just start using a simple pattern, a mandala. Mandalas are simple patterns that you can use to practice certain skills. So, what I'm going to show you is what I've discovered in the week that I've had this tablet, because it's brand new. So you will notice that this is not magic, not rocket science. It's just what I can do with a tablet. And I'm still learning. And of course, drawing on a tablet is very different than analog drawing. If there's questions already, you can just go ahead and fill up the pad, give your comments, whatever you like and whatever you feel like. The goal of this is that we get in contact, that we start an exchange, and if you want to, you can just watch, or if you feel motivated, grab a piece of paper and a pen and just try to do something. Try to create something and see what happens. I recently started experimenting with color, even though I hated coloring as a child. And I had a result which I liked pretty much, and I would even call it art. So, thinking about art is often not what brings the best results. Sometimes you should just try and experiment and have a casual conversation about art. And I'm excited to see what I'll see on Twitter or other networks in the end. So I'll just continue here. Are there any questions yet or statements? We don't have any questions yet, but you've motivated one person already to join. So my biggest goal is reached. This person says that she's never really done art or been into art, but she's motivated to try. That sounds fantastic. You don't have to stick to drawing. You could also use other forms of art, such as video or music. Anything that is an expression, is art in the end. So if you want to write a poem or express yourself in other ways, please do so. So maybe we can even have a more diverse display of art in the end, because you don't have to have drawing skills in order to create art. And I'm really happy to hear that people are already joining. I'm really happy to hear that. And you're absolutely welcome to join. And thank you for the compliment. I didn't think that I would receive that because I was so excited and nervous. And I don't think that I'll be even able to say all the things that I've noted down in my preparation.
Obwohl man das auch analog sehr schön machen könnte. Sollte vielleicht etwas mal sein, was ich übe.
Okay. I'll try to get inspired. I try to find some mandala motifs. And I wouldn't have thought about producing mandalas before I brought the tablet, although, of course, it would have been perfectly possible without. And mandalas are great because you can just jump in. And with each element, you can reconsider what you would like to do and then decide, maybe I want to put some circles in here. And that's the kind of work where you can really surprise yourself regarding what you end up with. And that's a lot of fun. When you can surprise yourself with your own creativity. Something that many people are afraid of because creativity is an amazing talent. People think you have to be born for it and not that's not something you can learn or practice. But someone put it that way, creativity is the recombination of things you already know. And that I found great because when I looked at some of the stories I'd written and noticed how much I had taken from other creators and changed for what I wanted to achieve, what I needed. That doesn't look too bad, but I would like to add some more something else in the center.
Ja, den letzten machen wir auch. Kommt auch noch was rein.
Ja. And the last one too. Yeah, I'm going to do that one too.
Noch irgendwas, was gerade zufällig ins Pad geflattert ist?
Im Moment haben wir da tatsächlich nichts, aber ich hätte da eine absurde Idee. Für Menschen, die sich trauen, was hinterher zu teilen, die können natürlich auch durchaus mal zusetzen, ob man das eventuell auch zeigen könnte. Vielleicht lass uns ja die Zeit am Ende mal 5 Minuten gucken, was
Something has something perhaps just fluttered into the pad. At the moment we don't actually have anything, but I have an absurd idea for those that dare to share. They could...
Eine hätte ich gerade noch, das ist das Thema
perhaps show what they've done, and maybe there will be time at the end what the rest of the world has drawn. Yes, that would be fantastic, of course. I'd love to look at that. And otherwise, as always, the pad is open, ask your questions. There is one I have regarding the title of your talk. Is this art or is it just pretty? Does that mean that art has to be pretty? No, not at all. There is art that is unbelievably ugly and that is off-putting, and some people think that it has to be disturbing. And that is the thing. Art is something that you can think a lot about and discuss a lot. There isn't a single opinion about art. I personally think there is no correct art and no art that is wrong. There's just the art that changes or causes something within you. And if it's ugly, thinking of maybe war veterans that use their art to process bad and terrifying experiences, that may not be beautiful art, not a nice picture to see a battlefield or something. That is really not nice, and that's not nothing that anyone ever would like to see. But still, this art expresses something that, for one person at least, perhaps was very, very important to perhaps let something out, get something out of your system. And that is interesting and important about art, that it's about many different functions. It may be ugly, it may cause debate, it may divide us. And that's what I've always liked about art. It's not just about expressing what is beautiful, but also what is terrifying. And that makes it a great outlet for people that identify with some form of art, which gets us back to the point that not just painting is art, but music is art as well. And music is a great way of screaming out my feelings into the world. If I cannot sing, then maybe I can dance. That too is a form of art, theater, drama, writing. Everything that you can use to kind of get out your feelings into the world. And that's all great and has a great place in the world. Just as what I'm doing right now has a place in the world. You might think that what I'm doing is just awful, but it relaxes me, and maybe some of you will be encouraged by this to say, hey, well, these lines are just wavy and not straight at all, but I'll just start trying and see what happens. And whether that ends up as something just beautiful, that is only one question. But as I said, this title I mainly chose because of the well-known German saying, is this art or can I throw it out? I didn't like that sentence. Art is not something to throw out. It has a sense, a purpose. Sometimes the purpose is to just be beautiful. That is, of course, the nicest purpose maybe that art may have. But sometimes it wants to shock. Sometimes it wants to get people to not engage in warfare. Or maybe talk about rape that they've experienced or violence. And as ugly as that may be, again, that has just as much a role as a beautiful mandala may have or something like that, something similar. Okay. And do you then think that there is anything at all that could be the opposite of art? Oh, that is a very good question. What could be the opposite of art that would be to not express anything, to don't say anything in any way? And then the question would be, how could that take shape? Could that take any shape at all? That would be then the question that you would have to ask. And I have to say, just spontaneously, I couldn't really give you an answer. It's a very interesting question, because if I don't connect anything with the thought of having an empty white room, again, that could express something. So in that sense, almost everything could be art. My clothes, the way I have my hair cut, and that all can express something. Actually, I believe that the nicer thought is that maybe there isn't an opposite to art, and everything to some extent is art, and art is always there somehow in some form. I think that is an answer I like. But it's a very good question. Yeah, you can philosophize, if that's a verb, a lot, because art is not easy, not simple, not one-dimensional, or rarely is.
Die mit Technik arbeitet, also zum Beispiel Floppy-Musik oder Schmuck aus Platinen oder ähnliches, und die Frage ist,
we've now got someone who is stressing that. This is someone who likes art a lot and works with digital media, floppy disks or circuit boards turned into art. And this person asks whether there are other forms of art that work with computer parts. Well, you could argue that every computer code could have a certain aesthetic. To someone, maybe someone would have an inkling towards very tidy code or the opposite. So every code in the way it works could have a very unique, very individualistic, but still an artistic function. And it could be an art to reorder things and maybe invent something new that way. That's how I would see it at the moment. Sometimes the question maybe isn't where there is no art, but where we can discover art in your everyday environment, where you don't normally notice. And I think that technology clearly is a part of human creativity being used to arrive at a certain point, and that, I think, is a form of art, don't you think? Maybe someone out there in the pad can answer whether they agree with that point of view or whether they disagree. He, she, or it, they may want to correct me if I'm talking nonsense. So let's have this debate.
So vieles, was etwas ausdrückt und wo wir so selten im Alltag drauf achten. Und was ich persönlich.
I'm one of the people that say you don't have to be able to, you don't have to have a huge skill to do art, to create something that you like. There are so many ways to express yourself that we normally don't really look at in everyday life, and that I think is very regrettable. And
magst du mir sonst irgendwann mal Bescheid sagen, wenn wir so auf die letzten 10 Minuten zugehen, dass man da vielleicht mal ein bisschen schauen kann, was die Leute gemalt haben oder sonst so in die Welt rausgeschmissen haben, weil ich habe gerade nicht wirklich die Uhr im Blick.
Na klar.
Ich verliere mich gerade wieder ein bisschen, so wie ich das so gerne tue, wenn ich anfange, einen Stift anzufassen.
Ja, aber darum geht's doch eigentlich auch, oder?
Natürlich, aber deswegen brauche ich da ein bisschen deine Hilfe, dass ihr ja da auch.
Could you let me know when we have approached the last 10 minutes? Because I'm losing sight of the clock and I would like to use the end for questions. I'm losing sight just as I always do when I pick up a pen. That's why I need your help to properly honor the people that are using going there.
Das ist doch was ganz Nettes. Aber wenn wir noch Zeit haben, fange ich auch noch mal Neues an. Und ups, scheiße. Ja, wenn man nicht genau aufpasst, na gut. Dann fangen wir halt wieder an. Ich dachte so.
So, this went wrong.
Der nicht. Das war ganz eigenes. Nee, den hätte ich gerne wieder.
Wird gerade noch gefragt, ob du einen favorisierten Hashtag hast, mit dem die Leute ihre Kunstwerke posten sollen.
Vielleicht tatsächlich den Hashtag, das ist Kunst.
Dann würde ich das mal so auch ins Pad schreiben, dass das Leute auch finden.
Das darfst du sehr gerne.
People are also asking whether you have a favorite hashtag that you use to publish your art. Maybe the hashtag would be "Das ist Kunst" or "This is Art" in English. Maybe that's I'll put it into the pad.
Mandala hier wahrscheinlich auch nochmal unter meinem Twitter-Account verwursten, nochmal raushauen. Nein, das gefällt mir nicht. Das gefällt mir nicht. Das machen wir nochmal anders.
And maybe I'll publish this mandala under my Twitter account.
Und dann im Zweifelsfall auch wieder löschen. Das muss ich wirklich sagen.
What is advantages about digital art is that you can try just about anything and if you don't like it, you just delete it.
So lernt man nicht aus.
Normally I prefer working with a brush, but you never stop learning. Maybe this wasn't 100% symmetric.
Ich glaube, ich will mein Schleifchen.
Was hier gerade noch so. One of my favorite ornaments. We have a question popping in.
Sehr spannende Frage.
Do you think
es gibt einen deutschen Künstler, der seit Corona auch relativ viel auf YouTube unterwegs ist, der heißt Fabian Navarro. Den kennt
something like people can create art, but I didn't understand correctly. There's a poetry artist who actually wrote a bot. Okay, it's about whether bots can create art. So there's someone who made a bot who wrote poems, which started an enormous discussion about whether that is art or not. And I think there's a lot to still discuss about. But my personal opinion is yes, that this is art. Because somebody created the bot. So it's still art, but art that has been started by human hand, even if it works on its own. So if people make a machine that makes art, I think the machine is art in the end. So what I'm doing is also machine-assisted art. Because I'm not using a brush to paint on paper, but I'm using digital means
Kunstwerk habe, weil ich ja
and I'm not even using my normal hand-eye coordination, which I usually apply when creating art, but looking at a screen. So that is also some kind of technical art right here. So I'm sure that robots can create art.
Und hast du, ich gehe jetzt mal auf dein Beispiel mit dem Gedicht, weil es auch zum Fragenstream gerade recht gut passt.
Gerne.
Coming back to your example about the poem, do you think that artificial intelligence can develop a sense of art or an understanding of art? Wow, that's a very philosophical question we're approaching here. I think ultimately, with today's knowledge, you can't tell. But when discussing whether AI might become conscious at some point, this would also involve, if we presume that AI can develop feelings and a consciousness, a consequence would be yes, that AI can develop aesthetic understanding.
Aber da sind wir dann auch wirklich auf einem ganz, ganz philosophischen Level.
But that takes us to a very, very philosophical level. And a very theoretical question that we're just not able to answer on a factual basis, and we would have to talk about whether we would even want AI to be able to develop that kind of understanding. But it's a very interesting question nonetheless. To imagine what aesthetical understanding would look like in a machine. I think before you said, that each kind of expression is always art. So an AI would just have to be able to express itself in order to create art. That's a good point.
So ein Detail gerade gar nicht mit einbezogen, aber ja. Aber
which I hadn't considered before. But yeah.
Die Frage ist ja, drückt die KI dann die
The question is whether
was glaube ich jetzt noch
AI still represents a human in the end, which nowadays I think still is the case. When talking about the poetry bot, for example, because the AI has learned to express the aesthetics or thoughts of the creator, of the one who wrote the code. I don't think that we've developed a level yet where the technological means can develop its own sense or understanding of creation. That's an interesting thought. I think this is a very, very interesting discussion that we're having right now, and I would never have expected us to even touch that level of philosophy in this talk today. Although AI is a very typical topic for a discussion like this. So your feedback on whether you like this format or not is very much appreciated. We would like to know about your thoughts on whether you were able to relax during this session, whether you found it interesting.
Oh, es wird weiter philosophisch.
Oh ja. Ja, damit. Lass
uns. It's getting more philosophical.
Wenn alles Kunst ist.
Bring on the philosophy.
Nichts Kunst. Und darauf aufbauen.
If everything is art, what is not art? And can art exist on its own without someone looking at it or criticizing it? This is a very interesting and good question. I find it difficult to answer it. Because on one hand,
wenn ich jetzt zum Beispiel meine Kunst betrachte, meine Kunst mache ich im Moment vor allem.
If looking at my own art,
Kunstwerke, die bei mir in der Schublade
liegen, my art is something I do for myself mainly, and there's so many pieces which are laying around at my home, which nobody has ever looked at. And I would still consider them art, although no one outside of myself has ever seen it or criticized it. And I wouldn't deem myself a recipient of my own art. On the other hand, I think that art is individual in a way that the recipient does their own art just by looking at the art, because when I create art for a certain purpose, that doesn't mean that the one who is looking at my art will do so for the same reasons as I did, or will find it pretty for the same reasons as I did. So I don't know if it's even possible to answer the scope of the question, because it raises a certain kind of paradoxon. I think this is a question that will keep revolving in my head for quite some time.
Ist ja auch durchaus faszinierend. Das kann und muss ja vielleicht auch nicht alles beantwortet werden.
It's absolutely fascinating to have questions which you can't answer for certain, especially in philosophy. For me, this is what makes philosophy so interesting.
Und ja, du hattest recht mit dem Punkt, die Menschen gehen noch mal mehr in Richtung KI.
You're right. People continued going into the AI direction. Is art created by AI worth less than art created by an artist by hand? That's an interesting question to raise, and I would do so myself. Is it worth less?
Ich glaube, ich würde die Frage anders stellen, ob Kunst ihren Wert.
I think I would rephrase the question. Because art creates a value of its own.
Meine Kunst aus denselben Gründen schätzt oder.
I wouldn't be able to say that other people would appreciate my art for the same values that I do.
Ich denke gerade ganz viel nach, während ich rede. Also deswegen kann es auch gut sein, dass wir jetzt nicht alles.
I'm thinking while speaking, so I don't know if what I'm saying is even making sense. But my first instinct would be to say no. You can't compare the values of human, because you would look at each respective kind of art in a different way. Because AI would maybe be able to create art that humans could have never even thought of. Maybe you'll be encouraged by the approach or the thought that people like the idea of your presentation. Somebody is saying as a feedback that they really like this kind of presentation that also gives philosophical insight. I appreciate that compliment very much because this presentation was a very spontaneous idea and I didn't even know if anybody would even be interested in watching this kind of talk. So it was conceptualized as an experiment, and I'm very happy to hear that people appreciate and like this kind of approach. Somebody else is saying, I like the format, I'm drawing on my tablet myself right now, and I did something which I normally wouldn't have thought of doing. I'm drawing stick figures, actually. I'm really happy to hear those kinds of compliments. And really, I was questioning before I held this talk whether this would actually encourage people to create, or if people would say, I don't need any motivation from outside because I have my own motivation. Whenever I visit Congress, I have so much fun looking at all the different things and installations that people bring along and present at Congress, and I'm always looking at those presentations with the eyes of a child, and I have the impression that many people out there question their own abilities to create art, are questioning their skills, and I just want to show people that you can find joy in very simple means of expressions. So that is what I wanted to show, and thank you very much for your praise. Motivation for two other questions? Of course. Someone is asking whether art is always a creationist thing, or whether destruction can also be art. I would pose a different question back. Isn't destroying also creating? Who says that pure destruction isn't a process of creating something new? Because thinking radically, I'm creating a piece of trash, a heap of trash that wasn't there before. And in the moment of destruction, maybe my personal feelings are despair and rage, and I just want to express that feeling. Destruction can be art, of course. Maybe the result isn't aesthetically pleasing, but this isn't the reason we do art for. The reason for doing art is not that in the end somebody says, I like that. That's not the reason we do art for. Okay, bonus round. What are we going to do in December? How are we going to push art to the virtual space? This is a very good question.
I'm not the kind of person that is very talented in writing code or something, but if there are people that would be interested in creating a space for the event in December where this could be done, I would be hugely happy about that. It would be great if perhaps you could open something like a painting cafe. Basically, it would have to be a place. I think at Congress there used to be an art area where technical art was exhibited. If you could use video, perhaps, or maybe use programming, coding in some way. And I'm sure that a lot is possible, but unfortunately, I'm not the person to put this into practice. But I could really imagine that, and I would be so happy if that was possible. A space that the community in advance and at the event could shape and design and turn into a huge arts exhibition with all kinds of things that I would think would be a great thing. Many people agree and say, yes, the Congress is art, so thumbs up. Well, yeah, we are a crazy creative bunch. So that's the reason why many parts of chaos actually exist. Hacking doesn't mean anything else than taking something that was purposed in some way and repurposing it. That too takes creativity, and that surely is a form of art as well. If you can derive a certain aesthetic from that, certain aesthetic value. And if you have the opportunity after there is a pointer to a website in the path that deals with AI-generated art explicitly. Yeah, that sounds very interesting. And I think that is something that in the last few years has been discussed more and more, and justifiably so, because we do live in the 21st century. Oops.
Krass.
Oh, hier kommt gerade die Idee auf, dass man ja vielleicht
bei RC3 das die Idee has just come up that maybe the RC3 logo could become a mandala that could be a template for everyone to use and maybe philosophize about art at the same time.
Auch da, ich meine, ich habe das jetzt schon ein paar Mal gesehen, dass Menschen
I've seen several times that people work on the same mandala.
Da sind Farbkombinationen
and they all look different. There are color combinations in there that make me think, oh, this, of course, this is so obvious, but I haven't thought of that. Someone else has the idea. I could really just jump with joy every time I see things like that. And that is really what chaos to me is all about. People coming together and presenting their ideas and valuing, appreciating what others do and experiencing that appreciation for what they have done. And that's why I say that we are this small creative bunch. Because we all think, what can I do? What can I change? And maybe I can do something that no one else has thought about before.
Ich meine, noch gibt's, glaube ich, gar kein Logo, oder?
I think there isn't a logo yet, is there?
Also ich kenne keins, aber das heißt nichts.
Well, I don't know of one, but that doesn't mean anything. That's true. That's true, but yeah. So let's keep our eyes open and see what maybe I'll be sent. And maybe by that time I'll be more familiar with that graphics tablet. Because that right now is a huge adventure for me. Yeah, one of the would-be artists says, I'm scribbling along, but I don't know the technology that well. Otherwise, you would have found my results on Mastodon already. Mastodon, that is a network that someone will have to explain to me in more detail at some point. I haven't really got into that yet. the different spaces there. But I will grab some people from my local chaos circle. I'm pretty sure that there are people in Flensburg. Yeah, I assume that there will be.
Mit betreiben weiß ich tatsächlich gar nicht. Habe ich bisher noch.
Whether they actually run such a service, I don't know. I haven't. There's no one I can think of. But that doesn't have to mean anything, because just like anyone, I am someone that doesn't know a lot of things. It just exists.
Ah, das kann ich denn da mal reinmalen.
Okay, what else could I draw in there? Some triangles.
Ich glaube, so wie ich drüber gerade darüber nachdenke, ich denke mal, das werde ich.
While I'm thinking about this, I'm sure that at Congress I will offer a workshop session or something, a scribbling meeting.
Die Idee finde ich eigentlich wirklich schön, dass man da noch mal so ein bisschen
mehr. I really like the idea of sitting together, just like we are now. Maybe about your to motivate you, there are some first shared works of art on Twitter that people have made. Oh, very nice. How much time is there left? Could we take a look at that, perhaps? We can. Should I just send you the links in Mumble? Yes, you can.
Gucken wir uns das doch mal an, da bin ich ja ganz gespannt.
So, let's take a look.
Das sieht nach einer Hand aus.
Is this art or is it just beautiful? Used for the first time and created with Moleskine Flow.
Das ist That's wirklich, the text. Ich guck das gerade an und muss wirklich.
I'm looking at it and I'm thinking, I have tried so often to draw a hand in my life and. There was the crafts art show that I once was at, and I noticed that hands are my nemesis. I couldn't have done it much better myself, particularly with digital means. I'm glad if I can just get a reasonably straight line into my documents. Hands are amazing. You think they are such a simple shape and you see them every day. Can't be that difficult. So, respect. Just to draw it ad hoc. And it looks like it was drawn as a single line without stopping. And I couldn't have done this better myself. That is quite amazing. Well, yeah, that is art. Anatomically, well, maybe. Who needs anatomical correctness?
Für anatomische Korrektheit bin ich heute
for
nicht hier.
Anatomical correctness is not what I came here for. I came Menschen, here
to trauen, das vielleicht dann auch heute zu teilen,
share art with people that like to create art and appreciate it. That's why I'm here. And more people seem to want to do it because the feedback pad now has a Jitsi session where people can show their art and inspire each other.
Ja, warum nicht?
Ja. Yeah, why not? Of
wenn
course.
Wenn da Lust hat, jemand,
if people want to
heute Abend ein Jitsi
start a Jitsi this evening, where we can meet,
und vielleicht mal
sit down together,
sich da gegenseitig ein
and maybe
erfreut und unterstützt, ja.
Just support each other and make each other a bit little happy.
Auch da, ich bin wirklich,
again,
ich bin ja nun mal technisch nicht der versierteste Mensch.
I am not a very technical person. I have never installed a Jitsi server. All of these Corona times, I never used them to get a Jitsi running.
Also da dürfen Sie sonst im Zweifelsfall gerne Menschen so, auch bei mir in der Twitter DM.
People are very welcome to send me a DM in Twitter if they want to join me and get something going.
Das ist doch mal eine Ansage.
Well, that is a plan.
Das Feedback weist sich darauf hin.
And the feedback
tells you that
the place to follow in Mastodon would be chaos.social.
Okay, ja, mich vielleicht damit einfach nochmal auseinandersetzen.
Well, maybe I'll take a closer look.
Ich hoffe übrigens, dass man nicht gerade den Regen zu dolle hört.
I hope that the rain that is coming down here is not too loud. The beautiful North German weather.
Ich denke wieder zu viel drüber nach, was ich hier malen möchte.
I'm einfach tun, Bier starting to think too much again. Just do, just make.
Ich bin ganz fasziniert. Das ist
I'm so
das,
fascinated.
Dachte,
that's not at all where I thought I would end up with this mandala.
Das macht es ja auch so spannend, die zu machen.
That's why it's so interesting to make them.
Am Ende sieht es ganz anders aus, als
you end up with something that's so different to what you were thinking of.
Die Gefahr hin, dass wir im Zweifelsfall kein volles mehr schaffen.
At the risk of not completing this next one, I am going to start a new one.
Symmetrisch wäre ja auch zu einfach.
Well, symmetric would be too easy.
So, nachdem du es vorhin ganz kurz von Mastodon hattest, haben wir jetzt tatsächlich Menschen auf Mastodon.
So, we were talking about Mastodon shortly. Now there's actually a Mastodon channel that is discussing. Let's have a look. Wow. I love the colors. Especially at the tip.
Ich bin sowieso so ein kleiner Grünfreak.
I'm a green freak, totally. I love green.
Das ist Palm Tentacle.
Palm Tentacle.
Sehr schön.
Very nice.
Sehr, sehr cool. Ja, dann verstehe ich
auch, was die brown what the brown dots are representing. It's a very nice idea to combine a palm and a tentacle.
Wow.
And why not? The result is definitely art, and I definitely don't think that you should throw it out, as you state in your caption. I think it can stay. It has a right to exist, just as any other piece of art. And sometimes art is about exercising, practicing, and while you're practicing, perfection is not the goal.
Sofern ich von Falschstellen überhaupt reden kann.
There is absolutely no wrong in art. You can't do wrong. You can only do wrong if you think art is a craft and something you have to have absolute skill to do.
Tatsächlich gar nicht so gut, wenn man nur von davon.
Sometimes I think it can be very frustrating if you can't achieve what you want to achieve. To like bash your own skills. My first creation is the caption of this image, and I'm seeing something very abstract in here. And I like abstract art because you can create very intricate things very quickly. And abstract art is also about just starting, not being afraid, not aiming for a certain outcome. And it's also about having fun. Sometimes I look at my own abstract art later in time, and I think about what did I actually try to achieve back then. And I see the results in a different way than I did when I was creating it. I'm seeing a little bit something like a dragon or a crocodile in this specific spot up here. It's very exciting. I like this style of art. So absolutely, go ahead and dare new things. The interpreters are greeting you and are asking whether silence is art and how they can interpret your silence. Translate silence. I think it's going to be difficult to translate silence, but of course silence can be art. Especially in theater, I've often seen silent moments that were silent on purpose, also in film. If you leave out the music and have silence, that's a very strong means of expression. And of course it's art. At the very least, it's art. And of course, it's difficult to translate if I'm saying nothing, if that was the purpose of the question.
Oh.
Well, I can't see the purpose of the question, obviously. But links on social networks have begun to appear, and I really like what we just created here, and I really like what people have in their heads and what they're willing to express. It's unbelievably difficult to get a parallel line. It's not going to be and to get any better, so we have to deal with what we have. Why not? Just one more little flower. Looking at the time, doesn't look like I'll be able to finish it in time, but I'll share it on Twitter as soon as it's done. Anyway, I've had tremendous fun today. Unfortunately, I deleted one of my artworks. That's my own fault, but I'm really happy to see that so many of you have posted their own artwork, and I'll be looking at the hashtag, continuing to look at the hashtag and see what pops in. I think many of us will do, and I would love to see you do so, because that was the idea behind this whole talk, to just try and express yourself. I think we've seen very nice examples, and I'm looking forward to maybe seeing other people who felt inspired and encouraged to go and create, because you can watch your own progress when you create more often and make it a habit. And you can have a lot of fun on the way. Looking at social networks and the pad, it looks like you've had a lot of success in inspiring people to go out and create and do some art. I'm happy to see that, and I would be happy if maybe I've led some people to discover a new hobby. I had a lot of fun today, and I hope you had too. What a nice conclusion to this talk. Thank you very much for presenting and drawing life. And thank you for daring to try something very different. Thank you for participating. Thank you for asking questions, for philosophizing. It was a lot of fun. Our next talk will be about organ pipes, an update on organ pipes. So we're happy to get your feedback on the presentation, on the art, on the format. And I encourage you to go on Twitter and on the other channels to see what people have posted. I think it's a very nice format, so thank you for that. Thank you.